First life hack, if you're working with decals, we have very ugly intersection with all objects in my scene. I have for all object in rendering tab. In advanced we have receives decals, so we need to uncheck this checkbox. And for all these objects we don't see any decal intersection with these objects. If you have many objects, we need to change z-axis. So if you want to find these decals, just type in Outliner mi underscore and you can find all your decals, and then we can change dimensions, change scale of your decals. So we have few axes, first of them x and y dimension. We can change size of your decal. And next, Z axis, we can change using this Z axis, we can change object to intersection with this decal. Next lifehack is VFX rendering with the focus. So I have this amazing camera and this beautiful defocus, but all my effects, for example, fire, it don't work correctly with DOF. There are no any DOF in this fire. So I'm going to find this effect and find the material and make some changing. So let's go to my Niagara system, fire Niagara system. Just press Ctrl B, double click. Let's go to mesh renderer, find shader or material. Then press on this small button and it find me a material instance for this fire. Double click on material instance. I'm going to find the parent material or master material, and in general tab I can find master material. This one, let's go to master material, and in details tab I'm going to find translucency, and I'm going to change translucency path to from before DOF to after DOF and press save. And in this case my effect is working fine with DOF. And you can change all this translucency pass parameters for all materials and all shaders for all your effects. If you have particles, fire, smoke and other effects, and you want to get correct the focus in effects, you need to change translucency pass from after DOF to before DOF. Next lifehack, if you're working with very thin objects, with this grass for example, we have this ugly disappearing of my geometry in big distances. So this grass has masked material and we need to change one parameter for this grass. Let's find material, this one, and let's find opacity mask clip value and change this parameter, for example 0.1, and press save. Let me check. So I got much better result. I have 100% screen percentage, and if you change, for example by 0.01, you will get much better result. Let me check. Yeah, very nice. Next important lifehack is about clip plane. So I have this amazing camera and I have this object in first plan, and I'm going to disable this object using clip plane for my camera. So I need to use this expression set near clip plane, and I'm going to set distance, for example 30 centimeters, and let me check. It's not enough because I have this yellow dots maybe 60 will be enough, maybe 50. Yeah, 50 is perfect. So this clip plane is working for all cameras and also for viewport. Let me check, let me show you. And you need to enable this clip plane when you render, and we can disable clip plane when you render from other cameras. You can disable this clip plane by setting 0 value and press enter. There are two ways render your stills from Unreal Engine 5. In architectural visualization, we often need to render only stills, not movie, but only one picture from your interior. So a simple way, first method, this is using this menu and high resolution screenshot. But first I need to press G and hide all game overrides, then go to engine settings and select cinematics, and then go to material quality level and press epic. And then you can create your high resolution screenshot using this menu. Set for example 2, press capture, and you get a screenshot of your viewport with very big resolution, this one, and some interesting result. But another more professional method, and this method allows you create your screenshot in best quality. I will show you. First we need to go to settings and activate engine content and plugin content, then go to engine and plugins, so many folders is opened, engine, plugins, this one, and let's go to movie render queue content, editor, stills, and in stills folder we need to run this blueprint class. Just press right mouse button and select run editor unity widget. So we get sequencer still setup. First moment I want to recommend you create your own preset. So we have few presets, draft and ultra, and also I created my own presets for stills. Just press double click on this cube icon, and you can create your own preset. For example, we need a JPEG still. We can activate anti-aliasing, for example, maybe 2 and 16, console variables, game overrides, and other settings you need, for example, CryptoMod pass if you want. I often render CryptoMod pass. Then in output directory you can set up your resolution, for example 4K, output directory, and press file, save as, and for example preset number 5. Yes. Next moment we can add only selected cameras. So inside Unreal I have a few cameras, and also I need to set up this clipping plane I showed few lessons ago. We can use this variable, set near clip plane, and put value, set near clip plane, and 100 180. Yeah, much better. Then we can open movie render queue, go to window, cinematic movie render queue, and this is old one, and we can select only camera you need. For example, first camera, all you can create for all cameras using this button. And also we can select preset for rendering, for example still ultra, and press create sequences for all cameras. And we can press render local, and waiting a few minutes because Ultra Settings has many samples, so we can see your render in small preview. My render is completed. Let's go to this folder, and I got four stills from four cameras. And if you open this guys in Nuke, you can get high resolution materials and very big ultra resolution. So result is much better than from high resolution screenshot from viewport. Next important life hack: if you have very big scene, for example few kilometers, and if you move your object to very big distances from the center of your scene, let me show you. For example, this moon, maybe I need to duplicate this. When you save and restart your project, some of your objects are disappeared, and in this outliner list we get unloaded status for objects in very big distances from the center of the scene. We need to go to world partition tab, then select all these cells and press right mouse button and press load selected cells. And we get all my unloaded objects, and there are no any grayed out objects in the down part of my outliner list. Next life hack is about lighting setup. So I'm going to remove all lights from this scene. Let's select all lights and press delete. And I got absolutely dark project. Then very, very easy method how to set up your lights. We need to go to window, environment light mixer, and press few buttons. Skylight, atmospheric light, skip this atmospheric light one, then press create sky atmosphere, volumetric cloud if you need, and height fog if you need. Then let's go to skylight and press real-time capture. And we get absolutely real-time and absolutely lighted scene in your project. Thanks for watching.